Greetings, beloved viewers. This is Gilles, and I come today to speak to you of a very big subject. I'm not gonna, I cannot say much about it. It is something that still I feel is would be interesting to talk about. It is just my view, my perception. You may not share that view, or you may have different view. Your own views are more important than mine. My view is more important for me. But it is just I'm talking about romantic relationships and deep soul connection. So we all have different relationship to relationship, and those we develop that as we learn and grow. First, I want to say that to me, romantic human relationship is somewhat of a pale substitute for the divine connection to God, to the higher aspect of divine love. Yet it is the sweetest, the most beautiful, the most powerful experience in human life. And so, if you have an open heart, a pure heart, you will often attract someone with an open heart, a pure heart. I'm personally in between relationships right now, but I've had many relationships, and so I can let us say that it is something that is really difficult to not be passionate about. It is something very deep, very powerful. I'm talking about true love, not passing infatuation. Also, every relationship have some kind of value, something to teach us. In often in infatuation, when it comes to just personal, just passionate, passing thing, ephemeral relationship, it is very much men and women have sometimes different perception of those things. Men would go more about what they hear, when men are more visual, what they see. That's what they say. That's why women wear makeup and men lie. So you have to be careful of the hollow effect, because when somebody sparks something in your heart, we have a tendency to only see the good side, to be blinded by this one spark, and so we eventually discover that this person is not as perfect as we thought. And so when you get into a relationship, you have to be ready to accept the whole person with all their energy. But then in terms of deep connection, deep relationship, those are soul plans, soul connections. They are really difficult to align with a true soulmate, because any true soulmate will point out all your mistakes in a way that no one else can do that. All your flaws will be reflected. So we seek the highest mirror as possible, a true match for who we are, but then we may not be always ready for such things, so we may be left with disappointment, and because we sometimes fail to align with that true soul spirit connection. Yet it is usually a catalyst for growth, and so everything has value. And everything will be fulfilled in the eternal process of evolution. But sometimes in time and space, we feel disconnect when we feel this deep love for someone, and it's not reciprocated in time. We feel a great loss and great sense of woundedness. So usually the people we align with are people that we have had many past life with. And so we come. It's usually people that come from our own soul family. For all families, all souls are created by groups and families. Because I was speaking of the halo effect, sometimes at the beginning of a relationship, we have a tendency to idolize the version, the vision of that person, and eventually we can come to disappointment. But so it is good to be clear before, not to be deluded. But usually when it comes to deep love and deep relationship, even if it's not fulfilled, it's usually there is great initiation and meaning behind those things, although it is a great challenge to align with those energies. What we seek is eventually to align with our ultimate soulmate, our true love. Of course, we cannot go shop for it. It is something that we have to wait for it to come to us. If we go shop for it, you get a bargain. But then how many, it doesn't matter how many times you've been disappointed by love or by romance. ideal. I mean, you can we can never give up on that. Sometimes we do. We say we want to give up, but then something come up, and we are back into the passion, into the interest. And but then once we enter into a true relationship, with a true love, there is a great sense of fulfillment that nothing can fill that void. Of course, that we already have this wholeness within ourselves, but if we have made life plan with someone, some other soul, then it needs to be fulfilled in order to bring us to our joy and happiness. So I hope this made sense to you and you find this message interesting. I hope you enjoy, if you're already in a true happy relationship, I hope you spend your whole life deepening in that soul connection. If sometimes relationship come to an end, it's no use to, when a relationship comes to an end, it means it was meant to come to an end. There is no need to run after something that has ended. But if you're looking for something, that someone to be a true match, your true love, keep your heart open and stay attuned to your inner spirit. It will be able to guide you to that process, and hope and pray and ask so that it may come to you with grace and ease, and so that we may both enjoy this truly fulfilling sense of connection that no one else will ever be able to give you. I thank you very much. I hope this message was interesting for you. I send you my love and blessing. Namaste.